Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome back to the beautiful Wrigley Field. I'm the voice of Wrigley Field, Jeremiah Paprocki. Welcome to the 2021 season ticket holder event. We welcome you back to the ballpark, and we want to thank you for your support of Chicago Cubs baseball, and we're looking forward to your continued support for many more seasons. Now, I know there's a lot of anticipation to get out to the field, but we have a special interview, so please stay in your seats until one of our videos plays. Once the video plays, then you guys can line up and go onto the field. But none of the field will not open until after the interview and the video. Got it? Sounds good. We'll kick it off. We'll start off with our special guest and an interview, and then I'll hand it over to Marquee Sports Network's Elise Menaker.
The bullpen struggled late and we fell short. So that led us to 2020. We had a really remarkable kind of summer camp after quarantine. David Ross and the players did an amazing job of, avoiding positive tests, coming out of the game strong, staying in shape throughout it. We started out 13-3, but after that start, we really struggled the rest of the way. We weren't an elite team in the rest of last season, struggled offensively, and obviously, at the end of the year, couldn't score against the Marlins in those two games. So that brought us to this season, we had sort of a crossroads of, what do we do with this roster? We have, 1 year left of these players and some free agents, and we decided again to bring this group back. We believe these guys have got to kind of one last hurrah in this group, and really up until late June, it looked like that was the right decision. Our bullpen was amazing in May. We got some really good performances out of some of those guys. But ultimately, we're in first place on June 24th. We lost 11 in a row, lost 9 games to the Brewers. And at that point, you're sort of forced to make a really hard decision, which is, we have 2 months left with a lot of these players. We're not going to win the division this year. We felt like the absolute right, but really difficult decision was to make those trades and to replenish our farm system. So it was difficult, and it was a transitional moment that, like I said, my job was to build the next trade on the team, and it was sort of that, that month leading up to it. Prior to the losing streak, I thought we were going to be buyers. I thought we were going to bolster the roster again, but we got to that place and realized we're going to transition and realize that next trade on the team looked a little bit different.
Transitioning after the trade deadline, and now it still feels like there will be a transition in the offseason. You have said that you would be more active, so can you explain what that looks like for this team moving forward, and how this could bring it back to
So I guess I would kind of look at it a couple ways. Number one, Chicago and do the same thing. I remember having a conversation with him on the phone before he moved to Chicago and before I moved here about exactly what we were going to do. And then they changed the rules on us and we realized that that plan was no longer going to work. We had to sit in the office and think about the right way to build this roster. So ultimately what we decided on was what you guys saw in 2012 and 2013-14. And obviously that was effective, but I don't actually believe that that will be effective again. Number of teams have tried that for a lot of various reasons. I think that that strategy no longer works. So what we're going to do is going to look different than last time. I think it's really important as you think through a strategy to make sure that it's not just based on this is what we do, but it's based on exactly this particular situation. And that's what we did last time. We kind of molded what we did to the situation. I do believe that the best strategy in our game is simply to make one good decision after another. That's something we talk about all the time. One good free agent signing after another is really well thought out and well researched. Same thing with trades, the same thing with the draft, the same thing with the international market. If you do that over and over, you're going to have a really good organization and things are going to happen quickly. I tell this story all the time because, frankly, it's humbling. When I was in St. Louis, it was kind of mid-June of 2013, and we were playing the Cardinals. There was a day game, it was a getaway day, end of a series. I think we lost the first two games. It was 2013, our team was not good. In fact, we ended up losing 96 games. And that particular day, I happened to be sitting by myself in the box, watching us play. And I kept looking out in the field thinking, how on earth are we going to beat these guys? We've been here for, I guess, a year and a half at that point, and I'm looking at a Cardinals team that made one World Series in 11, in 12, I think they lost to NLCS. In 13, later that summer, that fall, they lost to the Red Sox in the World Series. And I was looking at the field thinking, we're not even close to this team. They had just a fully formed adult roster with guys like and Matt Holliday, Matt Harbinger, and Adam Wainwright, and Lance Lynn. And it was just, we were so far from that at that moment. And so I took out my notebook and I wrote down their roster and I was writing down our pieces and then we got in line with these and it didn't make me feel that much better. And so 2 years and 3 months after that, we beat them in the division series. We won 97 games, and the team that we beat up there was almost exactly the same team that I was staring at in 2013. And so, when you look at our roster on that day in 2013 and how much it changed, we traded for Miguel Montero in the winter before the 2015 season. We signed David Ross as well. Rizzo was the first baseman on both of those teams. As Russell, we created